Hello and welcome. Today we're going to take a look at calibrating the pH probe using SPARKvue, either on the computer or on the SPARKscience learning system. The procedure is the same. Whether you are using a pH sensor, a pHORPISE sensor, a water quality sensor, or the chemistry sensor, you're going to be using the same procedure to calibrate for pH. I'm going to go ahead and use the chemistry sensor, and I'm going to connect that to my SparkLink. And then I'm going to take the probe, connect that to the end of the sensor. And you see on my screen that I have a variety of measurements that are now showing up. And I'm going to take the pH probe, and I'm going to remove the soaker bottle that comes with it, carefully. And I'll set that aside. And I'm going to take the O-ring that holds the cap, and I'm going to just move it back so it's out of the way, so I can still take measurements even though the cap is still there. And the first thing I want to do is rinse off that probe to make sure that it is good and clean, doesn't have any of that fluid still on it. And I can blot that dry if I want to, keep it from diluting the solutions I use. Now I'm ready to set up for calibration. So the first thing I want to do is create a spark lab, because that is where that calibration is going to be saved. So I can use either one of my paths. I could open a file, I could go to show, but I'm going to use build. And I'm going to select pH and create a couple of displays that are commonly used with pH. Once I have those in place, I'll say OK. And now I have a spark lab created. And that is, again, where my calibration is going to be saved. I'm going to go down to the tools in the lower right-hand corner here, and that is where I'll find the calibrate option. So let's select that. And you'll see it shows that I have the chemistry sensor connected. And the measurement that comes up by default is temperature. We want pH, so I'm going to touch on that to select for pH. And you see it's already set up for a two-point calibration. That's what we want to use with the pH sensor. So I will say next. You'll see it automatically comes up with the 2 points shown. I'm using a 4 buffer and a 10 buffer. You'll see it set up with 4 and 7 by default, but we can change that. So I'm going to start off with my 4. I'm going to take the probe and stick it into the 4 buffer, and I'm going to hit the read from sensor. And that's going to take a value from the sensor, and it's going to associate that with pH 4. Then I want to take that out and rinse it off thoroughly so I'm not mixing my buffers. Set that aside. I'll blot once more. And I'm going to put that in the pH of 10. So what I need to do on the screen here is change 7 to 10. Say OK. And I'm ready to read from that second point. I'm going to have to scroll down one and hit the read from sensor button, and now it's going to associate that value with a pH of 10. Now that I've finished the calibration, I can rinse that off. And once I say OK here, it's going to save that calibration with the file. Say OK again, and now I'm ready to measure. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to start collecting data, and I'm going to stick that in an unknown. This is a fruit juice, so I'm anticipating it will be an acid. And sure enough, looks like an acid to me. I only have to do this once at the beginning of an experiment, typically. So I can now go on and do several measurements. And as long as I'm still using this file, I should be OK. We hope you enjoy using this sensor with your students. And don't forget to practice safe science. Thank you.